In case I forget later, we are parked here at Cabana Bay Resort at Universal Orlando Resort. Hey guys, it's Ken. Welcome back to Theme Park Flavors, a vegan adventure where we explore some storytelling in theme parks and then eat some plant-based food. Today's no different. We are staying out here at Cabana Bay Resort to enjoy the evening festivities at Universal Orlando. Sometimes it's nice to just crash at a resort and go explore the parks at night, maybe have a few cocktails, not worry about getting back in your car and driving home. Just take the boat ferry back over here. Actually, there is no ferry. There's only bus service from Cabana Bay to City Walk. So we're taking this wonderful little walkway that connects Cabana Bay to Sapphire Falls, where we will hopefully secure a ride on a ferry boat. I mean, who doesn't love a ferry boat? I mean, any day on the water is a good day. Then we're headed to City Walk and Islands of Adventure for something I'm very excited to see. I've never seen it myself live, so can't wait to see it and share it with all of you. So thanks for tagging along. Let's go. This is actually a beautiful walkway that connects all the resorts. It's called the Garden Walk. You can connect yourself to Royal Pacific, Hard Rock Hotel, Portofino Bay, and of course, Sapphire Falls, Aventura, and Volcano Bay. Looks like we just missed the water taxi, but there is a walking trail along there that will also take you to City Walk, which is right across the way. There's our destination, Islands of Adventure. You know what? It's a beautiful night. What do you say we just hoof it? That way. This is a good reason to slow down, take your time, and go for a little walk. Right there in the water is mommy and a little baby duck. Right there. Just like that, we made it. Let's head inside Islands of Adventure. I don't typically need an adventure guide, but today I will because I'm here for one specific thing. Here's what we came for tonight: the magic of Christmas at Hogwarts Castle. As the stars begin to shine, stunning projections wrap Hogwarts Castle in a spectacular holiday spirit. Unfortunately, I bought this or picked this up hoping to be a time, but there's no time, so we'll just head that way and see what we can find. Sitting down to dinner, we'll head back out to Universal in just a moment, but I was speaking with a team member about the times of the projection show, and she said it all depends upon when they close. For example, tonight the park closes at 7. They have 4 shows between 6 and 7 p.m. Certain nights when they open till 10 o'clock, they have more shows, obviously, so I would recommend just heading to the park, getting in that standby line and waiting for the show to start. But let's head back to Universal, check out that amazing projection show, and head you back here to eat. Thank you. What can I say about that amazing show? Except I don't quite know where to start. There were tons of emotions attached to it. The visuals were stunning. The storytelling was amazing. The music was perfect to go along with the visuals. And speaking of music, I want to take a second real quick and pay a little tribute or a little respect to Mr. John Williams. If you think about all the amazing scores he's created over the years, Jurassic Park, Jaws, E.T., Indiana Jones, Superman, and of course, what we just witnessed, Harry Potter. Their music is just as important. In fact, there's the probably last show of the night right there. The show we just witnessed. Oh, speaking of amazing things, check this guy out. The Hulk. Anyway, moving on. So the water taxis were all full, jam-packed with people, and a big old long line to get back here. So I thought, you know what? We'll just hoof it. Now I left at 7:15, park closed at 7 o'clock. 7:15, I was hoofing it this way. When I get back to our resort, we'll see how long it took me. 7:33, so 15 minutes, give or take a few, to walk from CityWalk through Royal Pacific, through Sapphire Falls, then across the street here back to Cabana Bay.
Okay, so here at International Favorites in their food court, we have a General Tso's Mindful Chicken Stir Fry for $12.25, vegan plant-based protein and stir-fry veggies in General Tso's sauce on a bed of rice. All right, let's give it a try. Okay, here's our plant-based chicken. One thing I love from the start here are these mushrooms. I love mushrooms. First bite, the flavor is good. Could be a little warmer, a little hotter for a stir fry. But the veggies are nice and crisp, which I like. Let's try the chicken.
Not bad.
Looks pretty good. The chicken is actually flavored very well. Little snap peas in there, or snow peas rather. Overall, pretty good start. I like the added fresh sprouts on top. That's a nice touch. And again, the broccoli and veggies are not overcooked. They're still al dente. It's a good bite of broccoli. Get some of that sauce in there. But then bear it at the bottom. Is our rice. Okay, one final comment. For it being $12.95, it's not a bad portion. I mean, it's a big bowl of stir fry for that price. I say it's a winner. I would definitely get it again. That right there should say it all.
Thank you very much for taking time out of your day to watch my video, especially if you made it here all the way to the end. I have a fun little surprise at the end of today's video because I've been wearing my little boo hat around the parks because I can't get my hands on an Earl of Squirrel hat. They're all sold out. So Little Boo's coming along for the ride and we go back to the room and he and I had a little conversation. He's like, listen, Ken, if you're gonna take me into the theme parks, which is fine, I love going along for the ride, but if it's during the festive holiday season, I need to look the part. I need to be a little more festive. I said, okay, Lil Boo, what do you have in mind? Here's what we came up with. So there you go. Happy holidays, everyone. I'll see you in the next video.